All right, Rabotai, good morning to everybody. Se cortó la cabeza. Again, 1-1. Maybe there is no battery.
No. Está absurdo, está prendido.
Testing. Okay, good. All right, Rabotai, good morning to everybody again. Shiur dedicated to Nishmat Devorah Fege Bat Shemuel, Ora Devorah Bat Shemuel, Esther Rivka Bat Avraham, Monika Miriam Bat Fani, Menachem Mendel Ben El Hanan. Mamash approaching the days of Purim, and we know that one of the mitzvot, especially for the young people that they like very much on the day of Purim, is the concept of drinking. Right? Getting a little bit of alcohol, l'chaim. For us it's a tea, it's a coffee. For them it's a... You go to Israel the day of Purim, you feel Purim in every single corner. Everybody is like very happy. So somebody asked, I don't understand this concept. I mean, what Judaism is saying to be happy, right? And how Judaism is providing the happiness throughout drinking alcohol? That's happiness? Chayav inish revesume bepuria ad de lo yada. A person have to drink, you know, alcohol ad de lo yada until he will not recognize ben Baruch Haman Arur Mordechai. And that's the happiness? That's one question. Second question. We have item, the custom, especially with the kids, that when we say Haman in the Megillat Esther, we make a lot of noise. Which item do we use to make a lot of noise? It's called the Ra'ashan, right? How you call it in English, the Ra'ashan? Ra'ashan, right? Grogger, Yafe. Okay, what is this grogger? What's the whole point of the grogger? Why dafka the grogger? I mean, there's so many ways to make a noise, and why? By part of our happiness is to make noise. Usually you go to a wedding, there is music, not noise. If there is a lot of noise, people are getting, it's uncomfortable. Now, but then we have to understand what is behind the whole entire holiday of Purim. So let me tell you a story of somebody that I know, that happened to him mamash a while ago. He's a rabbi in Eretz Yisrael, and he was invited to Eid HaKodesh to give a class. What's Eid HaKodesh? Okay, so this Eid HaKodesh is not Jerusalem, it's Eilat. Eilat. You know Eilat? Eilat. He went to Eilat to get, they called him up for a Shabbaton. Baruch Hashem, Eilat of today, it's not the Eilat of 30 years ago, 20-something years ago. Eilat is having a huge change. There is a yeshiva in Eilat, few yeshivot. Anyway, this rabbi decides, listen, the organization that is preparing the Shabbaton called him up, and the rabbi said, listen, I wish to come, but you know, driving now all the way to Eilat, it's a long drive, it's not easy, but there is a flight. I'm ready to take the flight. If you're ready to provide it, I go for the Shabbat back and forth. And they said, no problem, Rabbi. For you, for your wife, and yalla. He says that he gets to the national flights in the Tel Aviv airport. And there was that, for that weekend, there was a lot of people that they wanted to get to Eilat. Long line, everybody waiting with the luggage. Says the rabbi, I was waiting, like everybody. And then right next to me, or let's say even behind me, there is a guy, not a religious guy, with his girlfriend. And he tells her, what is this? You think I'm going to wait at the whole line? Happened what happened, I'm not going to do the line. She looks at him, Tzadik, you're not going to make the line, you're not going to take the flight. He says, I don't care, I'm not making the line, I have an idea. And he takes her to the side, and the rabbi, without them knowing, was hearing. And he tells her, listen, listen, what are you going to do? You're going to make yourself that you have discapacity? No. Handicap. You're in a handicap. Type of handicap. Okay, you're going to start walking like a zombie, and I'm going to help you out. We're going to get the... She knew how to act well. They went out from whatever place they were going, and they were in. And she started to act. The rabbi realized that. He laughed. He was laughing. So the boy realized that the rabbi was laughing. And he says, Rabbi, what are you laughing for? He said, no, I'm just laughing. I just want to tell you that it's funny. That's number one. Number two, she's acting very well. Number three, let me tell you that also there is somebody else that laughs. Not only me. Yoshev b'shamayim Yitzhak. Hashem ilag lamo. But the Olam laughs about the shtuyot that we do. We think that we are wise guys. But the Olam is laughing. Don't worry. One thing I want to tell you. Sheker en lo raglayim. Whoever walks and goes with the sheker, with the lie, is not going to have success. Rabotai, to make the long story short, this guy says, yeah, Rabbi, okay, you stay in the line. His girlfriend continued making the whole show, and after a few minutes, really, there is one of the attendants that are coming, and she asked what's going on. He explained to her, listen, my girlfriend, she's like this and like that. Oh, no problem, let us bring the wheelchair. They bring the wheelchair, they cut the whole entire line, they get into the front, they make the checking, and everything went very easy. Just before he enters, he looks at the rabbi, says, Rabbi, you see? And he entered. Rabotai, the rabbi takes the flight, he gets to Eilat, and it was Erev Shabbat, 1 hour before Shabbat, Mashu Kaze. The rabbi wants to take some air, he leaves the hotel, and he goes to one of the streets nearby. To walk. He walks, and who he sees in front of him? The beautiful couple. So he calls up he knew the name already. He calls her up and says, hi. Ah, you're the rabbi from the airport? He says, yes. Rabbi, says the guy, there is a God in the world. I believe in Hashem 100%. He says, really, Shehayanu? What happened? He says, Rabbi, what can I tell you? This guy, once they pass and they made the check-in, after a few minutes, one of the attendants comes up to the couple and tells them, we're very sorry, but according to the regulation of the flight, your wife has to be sitting in the front. She needs a special chair. And the flight is booked. It's packed. So because it's packed, you will have to wait for next flight. 3 more hours. She said, what? No, it was a joke. And she stood up and she started to walk. Oh, you were making a joke. And I go all the way back to the line. And for sure, she's going to miss the flight. And she's not going to have a refund. So they got to Eilat and they said, we thought that we're going to be wise. But Borei Olam was laughing at us at the same moment. How the story end up? The rabbi said, where are you going now? No, we're going to a party, I don't know, to disco. He says, listen, before you go to the disco, come to my disco. I'm giving a shiur over here. Torah, nice shiur. Come sit down 5 minutes. The guy agreed, together with his girlfriend, and they sit down in the shiur. From 5 minutes, they sat for 2.5 hours. They finished the whole shiur, one shiur, and a song, and another shiur. When they finished the whole thing, the guy stood up. We're talking about a non-religious couple. And the boy stood up and he says to the rabbi, Rabbi, can I say a few words? Be'emet, they're going to be very short. He says, okay, go ahead. He stands up and he says, listen, my girlfriend, They live in Herzliya Pituach. Herzliya Pituach is one of the neighborhoods, the most expensive neighborhoods in Israel. She, her parents, very wealthy people. She's the only daughter. And all the money of the parents, they give her no limits. We have been all around the world. We're already 4 years together. All around the world we did. No limitations of money. Whatever you can imagine, we had. All the enjoyments. And then the guy started to cry. And he said, but it's my first time in my life that I really feel enjoyment for real inside my heart. These 2 hours that have just passed. Rabotai, do you know what's the whole concept of Purim? Purim, mishenichnas adar marbim besimcha, and the simcha, drinking, it's not actually to take a cup of whiskey and to drink. You can have a little bit of cup, not to get too crazy. But the idea is, hayav inish levesume, to take out your mind, your regular knowledge that you think that you trust in it, to put it to the side and to believe that there is somebody above everything that is the one that is managing everything. He laughs and he knows exactly what's going on in each one of us in our lives. You know what is that noise that we're making? Usually when you make a noise, you look from where the noise comes from. And then you realize, oh, the noise came from a motorcycle, from a plane that was passing. When there is a noise, you look, who is in charge of the noise? You know why on Purim we're making noise? To realize that whatever noise is happening in our lives, whatever earthquakes that we're having, behind it, there is somebody that is managing it. Rabotai, Purim, Hashem Apur, and Megillat Esther, Hashem Hester Panim, the Borei Olam, lives constantly with us, hiding himself. And we just have to find him. And the story of Purim, not even mention one time the name of Hashem, just to let you find God. Once you will find him, you will find him also in your life. To realize that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is Mashgiach, is looking at us in every single step that we do in our lives. Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen ve'amen. מיחד נבן הרשע אומר, הצעה הקדוש ברוך הוא לזכות יצא לפיכך. כנבא להם תורה ומצוות שאני אומר, אדוני חפץ מים צדקו, ידיר תורה וידיר. אמן. בעלמא דברה חירותי וימליך מלכותי ויצמח פורקני ויקרב. מחיי חון ובמחון ומחיי דכל בית ישראל בעגלה. אמן. רבה מברך לעלם ולמי על מיה יתברך וישתבח ויתפאר ויתרומם ויתנשא ויתהדר ויתעלה ויתהלל שמי דקודשה ועילה מן כל ברכתה אשר אתה תשבחתה ונחמתה עד אמינם בעלמא על ישראל והרבנן והתלמידי און ועל כל תלמידי תלמידי און דעסקין בוריתה קדישתה בי ביתרה עדן ודי בכל אתר ואתר יהא לנה ולון ונכון חינה וחיזה ונחמה והרב אמרו יש הנמה רבה מן שמיה חיים וסבה וישועה ונחמה ורמח והצלה לנו כל עמו ישראל אמן יעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל עמו ישראל אמן זה כבר I love stories. Yes. That's where he was. Hakam David Shema. He would walk in the street wherever he saw over there some kind of priest. Unbelievable. So
you don't know who he was also, they used to read the Zohar, that's what they knew so much, and this Aleichem Nejid knew every single Pazmon.